All right, let's get the view from the Hill as Canada goes to pot without criminal consequences. Liberal MP Bill Blair is the government's point man on the file. Colin Carrie is the Conservative health critic representing Oshawa. Nikki Ashton, NDP MP from Northern Manitoba, welcome to you all. Bill, I just had to get your thoughts quickly. What was your reaction to this report, and I presume the government's as well?
Actually, our government was very clear that we want to reduce and restrict the access that children have to marijuana and to take the profits away from organized crime and to take the steps necessary to protect the health of Canadians. Mm-hmm. To that end, we asked a task force led by Anne McClellan, but we had 9 eminently qualified Canadians who did an enormous amount of work for us. I'm really pleased with the work and the very comprehensive way in which they approached a very complex and challenging subject. And I think the recommendations will be very, very helpful to this government as we go forward.
Can you see that being the actual blueprint as this rolls out?
Again, let's be really clear. These are recommendations. Mm-hmm. And I think the task force approached the job that we gave them in a very responsible way and in a very broad examination of the challenges. They took an approach of, I think, a very cautious approach, mm-hmm. quite appropriately, in how to reduce the social and health harms related to cannabis use. And they've provided us with that evidence and with their recommendations, which I think they'll be very, very helpful. They are recommendations, but it is a very comprehensive review of a very complicated and challenging subject.
Sure is. Colin, Conservatives as happy with this report as the Liberals are?
No, you probably guessed it,
right?
Like, when our approach, we're looking at basically, we have to be very cognizant of the health and safety of Canadians, especially our youth. And to have the recommended age of 18, I think, is very concerning, considering most of the science and the evidence clearly states that up to the age 25, the developing brain, there could be actually permanent and serious psychological consequences of marijuana use. So that's one concern.
And the Canadian Medical Association, I believe, agreed with you on that, right?
They did, yeah. And then if you look at the issue of driving and operating motor vehicles mm-hmm. while impaired, really there's no really good test for it. So I've talked to union leaders around the country, and it's like, what about even people at work driving forklifts, things along these lines? What about school buses, things along those lines? So there's some serious things, I think, that this task force didn't really kind of bring forward, and maybe they compromised a little bit, mm-hmm. and that's unfortunate, because when you're dealing with the health and safety of Canadians, particularly our youth, we shouldn't be compromising.
I assume they're doing this now. The marijuana consumption in this country, I'm not sure it's going to increase dramatically under legalization, will it? It's just getting it away from the criminal element. And
you know what, though? And realistically, when the Prime Minister came forward, he said, Don, the purpose of this promise was to take the profits out of organized crime mm-hmm. and taking it out of the hands of kids. But mm-hmm. That's what he said a year ago. You flash forward a year today, you know as well as I do, in your community as well as mine, we have these illegal dispensaries popping up. Their number one sales item apparently is kid-friendly things like gummy bears, things along those mm-hmm. lines. The marijuana can be laced with pesticides. There's a mixed message out there, because on one hand, the government says by the spring, this is going to be legal, but you should be enforcing it on these people because it's still illegal. So, we've got the profits in organized crime and the kid-friendly stuff out there. So I think there's a lot of mixed messages here that we have to take a look at.
Let me just quickly get Nikki. I want to come back to you, though, because
sure.
former police chief that you are, I'm sure you got some thoughts on that.
Yeah.
Nikki, NDP reaction? Is this the way to go?
Yeah, well, I mean, the recommendations coming out of this report certainly don't live up to the commitment that Justin Trudeau made in the last election. He had a very clear commitment to legalization. Many people in my generation, many young Canadians, voted Liberal because of that commitment. And what we see out of this report is, a lot of devolution to the provinces of some major decisions, but more importantly, no commitment to decriminalize, and certainly no timeline around that either. The fact is that over the next year, 66,000 Canadians will be arrested for simple pot possession. 20,000 of them will be charged. This report, and certainly what this government is doing, will do nothing to deal with that. That's a real problem. It is certainly a broken promise, and Canadians expect better.
Yeah, let's hear your response to both of those, Bill. I mean, certainly the idea that we need a test to determine when users are under the influence.
Yeah.
You've spoken about that.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's be very clear. Right now, Canadians, particularly Canadian youth, use marijuana at higher rates than any other population anywhere in the world. The issue of impaired by drugs, and including marijuana, is a problem today. It's been a problem for decades. It's a problem that must be addressed, and we've said that very clearly. But at the same time, we recognize that the current system of prohibition is not helping to keep it away from kids, and it is facilitating enormous profits by organized crime. And organized crime is responsible for a lot of the violence and victimization that take place in our communities. So taking organized crime out of this business and doing a better job of restricting access to kids is what we said we were going to do. If I just sort of make complete, Nikki suggested that we made the commitment to legalize. That was only half the commitment. And I want to be really clear. The Prime Minister in the throne speech said, we are going to legalize, sure, regulate, and restrict. And for whatever reasons, they kind of leave that out of the discussion. But it's a really important part of it, because it's through the regulation and the restriction that we are going to achieve the public purpose aims of keeping it away from kids, protecting communities, and protecting the health of Canadians. Maybe disagreement, but I would encourage them to read this report. And in all of its complexity, I think the task force did a very good job of addressing a number of these issues, and I think some of the concerns that are being raised can be properly addressed by making yourself better informed.
Okay, Colin.
I think I'm going to disagree, because if you look at the lessons learned, we look at Colorado, the governor down there even said, if you're going to be moving forward with this, make sure that you move very slowly. It would be really disappointing for the Liberals, in order to fulfill a campaign promise, they wouldn't look at the science and the evidence behind this. In Colorado, that did not get rid of organized crime. If you look at the experience down there, organized crime is still quite happy in the Colorado experiment down in that way. So for a bill to say that we're going to take the money out of the hands of organized crime, it's simply false. It's false today.
Here we get the pesticides out of the pot that you were concerned about.
Do you want to know something? And that would be a good thing, wouldn't it? Yeah. But as Nikki said, this has been a bit of a disaster. You have kids that are getting records now. Mm-hmm. The Liberal government's fine for them to say, you know what, it's still illegal. So enforce the law, but as a police officer, okay, what would you really want to charge a young person? And if you look at the chief of police's,
let's ask him.
You know what, though? Yeah. He's a former police chief. The Association of Chiefs of Police said it should be a ticketable offense. And to give our party credit, at the last convention, we actually took that position. And I think Nikki's bringing forth, an idea here, because this is going to take years for these guys to put this into place. So it's a typical Liberal approach where you shoot and then aim.
Robert,
they're not landing
get
anywhere.
You the wine this up, Nikki, but I got to get your thoughts on that. You're a former police chief. You know the resources are scarce. Do you really want to be chasing 20, 30, 40,000 kids over the next year?
I spent my life protecting kids and keeping communities safe.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I've also been very much involved in the front line of fighting organized crime. I know from all that experience that organized crime is responsible for much of the violence, as I said, that take place in our community. We can do a better job. And that's why I support the legalization, regulation, and restriction of marijuana. I know we can do a much better job of keeping it out of the hands of kids.
Why not decriminalize now?
Right now, the decision to sell marijuana to kids is done by a criminal in a stairwell somewhere. It's a lot easier for a kid to buy marijuana today than it is to buy tobacco or alcohol. Now, on the issue of decriminalization, I think the evidence is clear, and the task force speaks to this. Decriminalization doesn't achieve any of the public purpose aims of reducing the social or health harms of marijuana use. It makes it easier for kids to access. It facilitates the criminal market. To speak to Colin's thing, he misrepresented us. He said there's mixed messages. Our government has been crystal clear, and I've said many, many times.
Don't shake the
law
finger there, Bill.
The law is the law.
That was your promise.
The law is the law is the law, and it should be obeyed. It should be enforced.
Sure. I mean, this is about a Liberal broken promise, plain and simple. Justin Trudeau ran on legalizing marijuana. We heard this message across the country. And what we're seeing today is his government stand by a report that not only doesn't talk about that, it doesn't even talk about decriminalizing without a timeline. And to Mr. Blair's comments, my colleague's comments, the failure to decriminalize is going to set tens of thousands of young Canadians and other Canadians as well back further and further. That is not what Canadians were presented with in the last election. It's certainly not what we had today.
Interesting discussion. Thank you all. It's a work in progress. We'll be talking again. Thank you all.